亚洲物流及航运会议2016，集合超过70名业界重量级讲者，面对障碍重重的市场，他们都带出正面信息。以下是主要演讲嘉宾的内容重点。
Hopefully, near the bottom in a lot of sectors. We've had massive fleet expansion following the great years of 2000 to 2008 on Chinese industrialization and so on. That's resulted really in an overtonnaging in most areas of the market, so that freight rates typically are low. We're seeing a recovery at the moment in dry bulk, particularly, but also in tankers, things are a bit better. I'm not sure that we've really turned a corner yet, but the fundamentals are beginning to improve.
1年2日的会议中，不同的讲者都展示了乐观正面的想法，例如有个别嘉宾就相信合并是班轮运输的趋势。
I've been working in liner shipping for 31 years, and actually I think the amount of consolidation we've seen in the last 2 years dwarfs the degree of consolidation we saw in certainly the 2 decades prior to that. Probably in for the medium term, this is a good trend.
亚洲物流及航运会议是亚洲同类行业会议中规模最大。今次會議吸引了約2000名來自34個國家和地區的人士參與。會議矚目之處是首日的主題論壇，一眾講者探討中國的發展藍圖，包括一帶一路的新機遇。其中一位發言嘉賓是國際頂尖貿易企業的首席執行官。
We as DP World, we are operating in 40 countries, 77 terminals. We are on the Belt Road already, and we participate in it. And actually, in our terminal in Dubai, almost 40% of the export of China to the region comes through our port. So the One Belt One Road has started. Hong Kong will play a major role in the One Belt One Road. If you look at the finance side, there is nobody who's more familiar.In raising finance for China than Hong Kong. And there are many young, educated financial executives who will be the right people to develop that.
一帶一路被視為解決航運業問題的積極方案，針對貨運能力過剩及運費下降的困境。
We're very excited actually about the Belt and Road Initiative. We're an industry that is suffering from a lack of global demand at the moment. To our eyes, the Belt and Road Initiative is one of the few things out there which really seeks to stimulate demand. One of their goals is to create $2.5 trillion of additional trade in the next 10 years. That's really something to get excited about and to aim for.
会议期间一共有109家参展商，包括加拿大集装箱运输公司 CN， 以及采用最新科技的鲁帕特王子港港务局。它标志着加拿大在国际航运上日益重要的角色。
We've grown very quickly, opened up our container terminal in 2007, so next year will be our 10-year anniversary. But over that period of time, we've been among the fastest growing container ports in North America, and we continue to see year-over-year growth.
We were invited to come and present a Canadian panel. We're here to tell the story of how the Canadian Gateway is a very efficient, effective, and cost-effective way to get product from Asia into North America.
第二日的会议主题检视跨境电子商务。中国网络巨头阿里巴巴国际部门派出了代表讲解一个全新的企业对企业及企业对客户的在线商贸模式。
E-commerce 将来5年到10年呢，我觉得有三个最大的可能的方向。第一个叫收手，就是社交，在这中间能够享受购物和交换你的思想的这一个过程。第二个呢，我认为是个性化购物呢，将来其实上是一个个性化需求的最好的体现和表达。第三个事情呢，我认为是 novel， 就是新奇，人们还有一种不断的寻求新鲜的体验或新鲜的产品的这个需求，而这种肠胃的需求呢，往往就是我认为就是电商，尤其是跨境电商立足的一个最大的根本。
创新是物流和航运业的未来。亚洲物流及航运会议是亚洲最重要的年度盛事，
这是一个能够把整个亚太地区物流提供商聚合在一起的一个 conference， 在思想上的交流和 idea 上的碰撞呢，会对我们商业的布局会形成非常大的帮助。
I think it's probably one of the biggest, or if not the biggest, logistics and maritime conference in Asia now. And I think as an industry practitioner, I'm very happy to see such a good and well-run conference promoting our industry, also promoting Hong Kong.